Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes, day 34. In previous session, we discussed about time. So, lesson number 14, time. Let us continue the second chapter. So, today we are going to discuss about time. So, yesterday we learned how to read the time shown by the clock. So, yesterday we learned how to read the hour. Okay? Whole hour. So, today, let us continue the unit 14, time. So, observe here, children. I have drawn few clock faces on a board. Okay, now see here. The long hand pointing at 3. Okay, so what is the position of long hand? 3. So, long hand means minute hand. So, here I will write the position of hand. Minute hand pointing at 3. Okay? The short hand pointing little after 1. Okay? Our hand pointing at little after 1. So what is the time shown by the given clock? So children, the long hand pointing at 3 means 15 minutes. So we can read and write the time in two ways. For example, in figure we can write 1:15. Okay? So what is the time shown by the clock in figure 1:15? So we can write it words in two ways. Okay, for example, we can say it is 1:15.
What is the time shown by the clock? 8:15. position of minute hand and the hour hand. Okay? Now, shall we take some more examples, children? Now, see here. The long hand pointing at 6. Okay? So, the long hand pointing at 6. The short hand pointing between 1 and 2. So, what is the time shown by the clock? So, here you can write 1:30 in figures. Or you can write in word half past 1. Or you can write 30 minutes to 2 o'clock. Okay? Now, one more example. The long hand pointing at 6. Okay? The short hand pointing between 8 and 9. So, what is the time shown by the clock? So, here you can write in figure 8:30. Okay? Or you can write in word as half past 8. Half past 8, or else you can write 30 minutes to 9. Got it, children? Now, one more example. The long hand pointing at 6. The short hand between 10 and 11. So, what is the time shown by the clock? So, you can write here 10:30. Or you can write in words as half past 10. Or else you can write 30 minutes to 11 o'clock. So this is the way of reading the time shown by the given clock. So when you are reading the time, remember children, you have to observe the position of long hand and short hand. Okay? So, see here children, observe the minute hand. Okay? So, when it is half past, okay? When it is half past, okay? When it is half past, the minute hand is the minute hand is on number blank on a clock face. Okay? So, observe me children. When it is half past, the minute hand always pointing at the number 6 on a clock face. Okay? So remember children, when it is half past, the minute hand is on a number 6 on a clock face. Okay? When it was quarter past, okay? When it is quarter past, the minute hand always pointing at 3 on a clock face. Okay? Now, look at the next example, children. Okay? Here, the long hand pointing at 9. Okay? The short hand pointing little before 2. So, what is the time shown by the clock? So, see here children, the minute hand pointing at 9. Okay? Hour hand pointing
2.
Okay? So this is the two ways of writing the time in words. Okay?
When the long hand pointing at 9, the short hand pointing little before 2. The time is 1:45 in figure. In words, we can say 1:45 to 2. Or we can say 15 minutes to 2. Got it, children? So, after here, one more example. The long hand pointing at 9. Okay? The short hand little before 5. So what is the time shown by the clock? Okay, so here you can write it as 4:45 in figure. In words, you can write as 4:45 o'clock. Okay, or else we can say 45 minutes past four. Okay, now one more example. The long hand pointing at 9, the short hand little before 1. So what is the time shown by the given clock? So here you can write in figure as 12:45. In words, you can write 1:45. Okay? So like this, you should read and write the time shown by the given clock. So one more example, children. The long hand pointing at 9. Okay? The short hand little before 6. So what is the time shown by the given clock? So you can write it in figure as 5:45, or you can write in words as 5:45. Or you can write 45 minutes past 6. Sorry, 45 minutes past 5. So this is the way of reading the time shown by the given clock face. So children, here we have divided a whole hour in 4 equal parts. For example, here, see, so it is a 1 clock face. So here we divide it in 12 equal parts. Okay, above 12, below 6, 9, 3,
It is represent as 1 by 2. Okay? So, 60, if we divide in 2 equal parts, 30 minutes.
AM means
p.m. So here, midnight to afternoon 12 hours. Here also, afternoon to midnight 12 hours as known as a.m. and p.m. Got it, children? So when we are reading the timetable, okay, you might be saying first period 9 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. like that. If you are saying the afternoon timetable after the lunch break, okay, 2:15 to 3 p.m. like that. Okay, you can observe your class timetable. Okay. You will come to know the a.m. and p.m. Okay? So, here children, division of time we can write as, okay? So, here 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. Okay? 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. Okay, so 24 hours is equal to 1 day. Okay, so 7 days equal to 1 week. Okay, so 12 months is equal to 1 year. Okay, so here we can say 365 days equal to 1 year. Okay, so a whole year has 365 days. So about days of the week, months of the year, days in a year. Okay, these are part of a calendar. So about calendar we will discuss in our next class. Okay, so about the calendar we will learn more in our next class. So today we will discuss only about division of time here. So here we are dividing time as small unit, big unit, biggest units. So here 1 month, 1 month is equal to 30 or 31 days. Okay, a month has 30 or 31 days. Okay, so here 4 or 5 weeks is equal to 1 month. Okay, so we can make one more point here. 52 weeks equal to 1 year. Okay, so there are 52 weeks in 1 year. So by reading this point, your curiosity is increasing. Okay, you are eager to learn about calendar. So children, in next class we will learn about calendar. Okay, so today we discussed about how to read and write the time shown by the given clock face. So children, now it's time to end our today's class. Okay, so before ending the class, listen here children, you can make a day planner. Okay, in your mathematics book you can make a planner. Okay, what you have to do is when you get up in the morning, see the clock face and note down the time, what time you got up. Okay, so afterwards when we go to brush, take a bath, okay, when you complete your routine activities, again come back and see the time and note it in your planner. So how much time you spend Okay? So when you are going for breakfast, again you observe the clock face and see what time you are going for have your breakfast. When you complete your breakfast, again you can observe the clock and see what time you have completed your breakfast. Okay? So when you are going to attend your virtual class, just see the time and note it in your planner what time you are started to attend your class. When you complete to attend your virtual classes, then again write what time you have completed. Then you can see how much time you spend to watch the virtual classes. Okay, when you are going to have lunch, note the time in your planner what time you are going for lunch. When you finish your lunch, again see the clock and enter the time what time you finish your lunch. Okay, when you are going to play in the evening, you can write the time what time you are going to play outside. When you come back home, again you can see the clock and write in your planner how much time you spent to play. Okay, after play you will sit for homework. So when you are sitting for doing the homework, note down the time by seeing the clock what time you are sitting for homework. When you complete your homework, after completion of homework, again observe the clock, note down the time in your planner. Okay? When you go for dinner, again see the clock, write the time in your planner. When you finish your dinner, again enter the time. Okay? When you are going to sleep, okay? Before going to sleep, again see the clock, write the time in your planner. Okay? Then morning when you will get up, again you can see the clock and write the time when you got up. Okay? If you do this activity for a whole week, okay? Day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4 like this, 7 days, I am sure you will be able to tell the time shown by the clock face. Is that clear, children? Are you following it? You can take your parents' help and beginning it may be you find little difficult to read the time by shown by the clock. So you can take your parents' help with the guidelines of your parents. You can start entering the time. Okay? If you observe the clock face oftenly whole week, you will be able to tell the time. Is that clear, children? I hope you will follow it and you will practice to read and write the time. Okay? So will you follow it? Okay, you can take your parents' help to do this activity. You have to make a planner of 7 days. Okay? And after completion of 7 days, you can click a photo and send to me in WhatsApp. Okay? I will observe whatever activities you have done in a day. Okay? Now children, now it's time to end our today's class. So before ending the class, take down the homework. Today's homework, same as classwork one time. You can learn and write these notes in your mathematics notebook one time. If you find difficult to draw the clock face, ask your parents to draw and give you. Okay? At the beginning, you can take your parents' help. When you will be perfect to draw the clock face, you can start drawing your own. Okay? So, remaining things we will discuss in our next class. So, till then, take care. Bye-bye.